So I got a nice milled up straight piece of wood here that I can hold flat. Try this 3-pounder first. Yeah, that's tight. Here it comes. Cracked anything? Looking good. So you remember how I can get up on top of my table? Because I just pull those big drawers out of my ultimate work table. I can just use them as stair steps. I've had people write me and go, "Oh, those drawers are going to break as soon as you put anything in them." Not only do they have a couple hundred pounds of stuff in them, but then I use my full body weight on them too, so in your face. I'm gonna make a little correction right here. So this piece is gonna fit like this, but I don't want where this is gonna come down here and make that slot for the drawer bottom. I don't want this tenon to be that close. I want there to be a little bit of a gap in between. So I think I'm gonna shorten this back another 7/16 or something like that, you know, to get it back there a little bit. And then I'll just address this here, and then I'll just remark it. But I want there to be a solid gap that I fill to, so this just doesn't spill over and be part of that tenon down there, or that mortise, I mean. Okay, I'm gonna waste some material first, and you know, just get rid of some stuff while I cut these mortises and then the slots for the drawer bottoms. So I'm just gonna get rid of it, and then I'm gonna sneak up on my exact measurements using these actual pieces, because I want this to fit absolutely perfect, flush in line with the bottom, because this hole where the bushing goes in is very, very important that I get it flush on my reference bottom side, because when I drill the hole in the inside bottom of this for the bushing, it's very important, otherwise I could have the axle kind of tilted. So I'm going to sneak up on this. This is one of my
favorite things. And I get a nice clean cut that way. But I've got the big Festool hooked up with the edge guide, and I'm just gonna, you know, take my time, try to keep most of the dust down. I got a quarter inch bit, and I need to end up at about 3/8. So I'm just basically taking the middle out right now. I always like to unplug it, either put it on the floor or unplug it before I start setting up, so I don't drag it off the table by the cord. I like to pull this off too, just because I'm kind of a maniac in my shop. Okay, let me check out where I am right now and get the router set up for the next step. So it should just be, you know, a feathering cut here on the inside and then one on the outside, and should be good. But I just want to do it. I just want to be really, really accurate with this.
Thanks for watching. We have woodworking plans available in our store, and we'll continue to add more. Each set of plans corresponds with a free video series available on YouTube.